everyone, it's Cece, and I have the Huda Beauty Desert Dusk Palette. Isn't this gorgeous? All right, great. Right into it. I was really excited about this because the Rose Gold Palette is the one that I take out for any kind of special occasion I might have. Even if it's just, you know, dinner with family or friends or family party or something like that. That's the palette I grab for. I think it's really special. It makes me feel special. And I really love the purpley shades and taupe shades, so I'm really happy with this palette. But today is the first day of fall, and you'll probably see this early next week. And I'm going to go for a pumpkin spice kind of look. And I've got my mirror right here. And this shade is Eden. It's a nice little peach shade. And you'll see, you just touch your brush in there. And it picks up a lot of pigment. So this is harder to do than I ever thought, you know, watching YouTube videos. But I have all my face makeup on. I am baking under my eyes a little bit. Really don't know how to bake. I'm going to go into Amber, which is right next to Eden. I'm going to set that on my outer lids. Blend all that together. Yeah, but this process, to all the big YouTubers who haven't figured out, congratulations. Obviously off camera there. Obviously I have all my face makeup on, I'm baking under my eyes, my brows are on, I have a little bit of contour, but no blush, because after this I am going to talk about the new Hourglass Ambient Lighting Palette, edit, Volume 3, and that will be a separate video. So next we're going to go in with Blazing, which is in this bottom corner, and I'm going to pick it up with a smaller brush. It's right here in the corner. It's a beautiful orange. I'm just going to add a little bit of that more into the crease in the outer corner there. Let's go really, kind of want a soft, blown out look here, actually. I feel like, I'm going for, but I absolutely love the purples in this palette. So if you like this and would like to see something with more of the purples, that's really what I thought I'd go in with first. But this first day of fall thing, saying, man, I want to go for pumpkin spice, even though I don't like pumpkin spice. What about you? I love fall drinks at Starbucks. I love the white salted caramel mocha, but I go for the white mocha instead of the regular mocha. Although I like mocha, I feel like there's it's a little heavy, a little powdery. I prefer the white mocha. I think it's smoother, creamier. I love that. My friend told me about white mochas, and then the guy at my Target Starbucks told me about doing the salted caramel white mocha. Looking at this, I am just gonna go in for Blood Moon, which is this beautiful shimmery shade right here on top. It looks so smooth and creamy. Yeah. Brush picks up a lot, and it's a little powdery when you do that. Oh. This looks like I just foiled the shadow, and I am going to work later on. Oh my gosh. I just really, usually with a lid shade, I like, you know, smooth it on that. I just padded. Both eyes. I don't. I don't think it's too much. I wear glasses, as you know from most of my videos. So a lot of this, you know, kind of, I feel kind of gets hidden behind my glasses, and it's okay. All right. So what do I do on the lower lash line? I've been loving this brush for the lower lash line, and I think I'm gonna go with Quad, Q-U-D. It's a brown. I'm gonna start at the corner, and then probably bring amber right over that. And yeah, this is. Oh, it's warm. It's really nice. I might not need amber. I'm just kind of smudging. Smudge. One tiny dip of this brush into it does the whole lower lash line though. Really don't have any fallout from this, and the colors are blending and applying so smoothly. So smoothly. I have my color switch, Vera Mona here, Sephora edition. So I'm gonna take that smaller brush, clear it out, and then just kind of see what kind of smudging I can get there with that. That seems as if it's the best liner shade, so I'm gonna stick with that and go for the upper lashes. I've been using a lot of. Not real deep though. I'm gonna try Musk, see how that works. It's this taupe shade. The one in the Anastasia Beverly Hills palette that's that color. Turns a real cool line of color on me. Yeah, that does not work. Not work at all. But since we're doing this, I'm just gonna go with Quad. Kind of smudge that. It might not be a real liner. I'm just going to use it towards the outer corner, and then I'm going to go in with my Kat Von D liner in the brown color. I think it's Mad Max brown. Do that real quick. I say real quick, but just to give it a little definition. That's a good brown. Just super close to the lash line. I can't see if you can see. And maybe a little wing. Boy, that lid shade is absolutely gorgeous. And I think it all is. I have a little lip balm on from MAC Cosmetics. The rose shade. Wow. This look came together really quickly. I'm only 8 minutes into the video, and of course I've been talking. On my brow bone, I could have used the color from a palette, I think, but I do have the Laura Geller French Vanilla highlight right in here. I think it just really blends together beautifully. And I have realized that I don't like a lot of too warm shades under my eyes. I think it's not a good one. I really like this mascara, but I'm having a little bit of an issue with it getting it on my shadow lately. So I'm just gonna do a little bit while we're on camera so you can see the finished look. Do you guys have either of these palettes? Because so far, I'm loving both of them. Really just loving. I mean, this was completely amazing. Easy to work with. I found that, you know, with the Rose Gold palette, that they do last long, they wear well. The shiny shades are either you know, not all of them are like this color that are so potent. They all kind of have their own little thing about them, but I just love them. I just, you know, I don't know, would I buy a blue or green palette from her, you know, with only blue shadows? Or I don't know, she could probably sell me anything at this point. It would be cool to see a neutral palette, but I think both her and I like pops of color. So something maybe a little bit more neutral, but maybe with some greens, you know, added in. This shade, Twilight, was really nice. I think it is supposed to be a shadow topper color. And it was just, it stayed on. It was over like a creamy base shimmery color. But you could still see that, you know, that kind of reflect with the light. It was gorgeous. But I would love to do a look. I think this retrograde will provide an interesting color too. It's purpley taupe. So I'd love to do a look with, you know, these purple shades if you're interested in seeing it from me. And the Celestial. That one looks like a different kind of formula. And I've heard this Cosmo color is just pure glitter, won't stick. Don't even bother using it. It looks pretty in the palette though. So let me know, have you tried the Huda palettes so far? Incredibly impressed. Love the other one. Let me know what you think. I know there were some iffy reviews on the other one, but I ended up actually going an hour out of my way each way for that palette. So let me know, and I'm so happy I did. I really am. And it was raining. It was bad. But let me know if you love these palettes or if you're interested in this one. I think it's a great one. Thanks so much, you guys. Comment below, please. Love to talk to you.